MREC TV.
Here's MREC, you know a rep, NYC, and I'm the best ever, Mayweather, TBE.
MREC, right? It's your boy Marquise, man, you're not throwing the MREC TV.
Because he's from Marcy, you know, usually we don't get along. But we've always gotten along, certain people, and like I said, it's my big brother who basically raised me. And you know, I was always in the biz, you know, and you know, he was dabbling in the biz, and he just, we always talked about coming together to make something happen. So about 2 years ago, he was like, yo, E, I'm ready, you know, and I was like, you sure? He's like, yeah, I'm ready. And me and Ron, we was doing a project called Brooklyn Boys. And you know, for whatever reason, that didn't pan out. You know, we're still working on that, but that didn't pan out at the time. And we were like a little disappointed and frustrated. And I was like, don't worry, something right around the corner. So when my big bro hollered at me, I was like, all right, I'm gonna put y'all two together. Cause it was originally he wanted to do something that was just based on what he'd been through, his life and everything. And when I put them two together, just magic just happened. And the story that this guy came up with and mixed in gentrification and everything with, you know, his story and the you know, the different elements and the three kings, and he could explain all that. Or you want to explain? Yeah, the stuff that he mixed in there is just like it's real deep, like, you know, because I unless you know the stories of the three kings and ISIS and all that, you know, I'll let you explain that part.
Well, it would also be great to hear, like, as you guys as actors were reading the script, like, what did you think? You know, when you were reading for this, were you reading for, like, the script for a specific role? And, like, what was your thought when you first read through it? It would be great to hear your thoughts on it.
So when I received the script, it was pretty like open-ended. I was just reading it from a very honest place. I wasn't reading it myself for a specific role. There was just so much texture, you know, so many different dynamics for the characters. And that's what drew me to the project more than anything else. Been acting for a very, very long time. I've done different types of films. And one of the things that drew me to this project was because it just wasn't like another black film, you know what I mean, with drugs and guns and drug dealers. And I've done those before. And I like the texture of it because there's so many different colors, races, and so many different dynamics. My character's Crystal. I know some people thought I was the other girl. Some people already asked me.
Which one was that one?
She was getting it in. That wasn't me.
So that's not you.
That's not me. Okay. That wasn't me. I played Crystal. I played Prophet's wife. And, you know, when I first read the role, I was just like, oh man, she can't kill anybody. Like, I like roles that are just so different from me. She doesn't shoot anybody. She doesn't rob anybody. She's not shooting drugs. She's not whatever. But one of the things that I liked about my with Prophet's kind of like, well, what makes your character important, you know? And one of the things I like is because it showed, just like his relationship with his grandmother, it showed his sensitive side, you know what I mean? Like, he was doing his thing out there, but, you know, he's a dad, he's a husband, and we were always together, you know, regardless of my attitude issues, and those type of things, but our relationship was close enough to where we talked about every and anything. I knew what was going on. I knew that it was important for me to always be upfront, honest, and convey certain things. So one of the most exciting things I'm looking forward to is the continuation of the project, because I want to see what happens next. I'm looking forward to see what happens, you know, next. You know what I mean? What is this recovery going to be like, and how I'm going to, like, how I'm going to deal with that.
Me reading the script, it meant a lot of things to me because I'm from Bushwick, so I'm not too far from Marcy Rutherford, actually. So the whole gentrification aspect hit me in a very deep place, because there's a lot of people, there's many people being displaced. through the gentrification and, you know, fucked up landlords and conniving ways and doing things in a very, with malintent to uproot our people from our communities that we've been there for over 30 years. So that was the first part that touched me. Second part that stuck with me, that resonated with me, is this character Santiago that I was reading for. Now, we're talking about somebody that kills his nephew about two scenes in. Actually, in the first 2 minutes, he shoots his nephew. He gets somebody to shoot his nephew. And then after that, later on, and, you know, finishes the job himself. You know, he actually goes and does it on his own. So a lot of what I brought to that character was, you know, we're talking about somebody who's living on the edge. I mean, like, off the edge, like, you know, way more than Lil Uzi Vert, you know, like, so this guy's, like, flying off the handle. So, you know, that kind of resonated with me because, like, you know, typically when I'm acting, I do, like, the police officer or the black drug dealer. A lot of people don't know that I'm Dominican sometimes on camera because I come off as, you know, like, African American. And that's the third point that resonated with me. There's a whole other subplot and another scene that was actually removed from the film, which actually talks about being Dominican, which I am. I'm Dominican, and I consider myself Afro-Latino. You know, I'm a black Dominican, and I've been black my whole life. There's a lot of, especially the car scene that when Angel talks about, you know, like, we all make it in this car, and, Dominicans, they get kind of touchy when it comes to being called black. A lot of Dominicans don't embrace their African-American roots or heritage. Yeah, we'll see moving, right? And then, so that was another huge part that kind of resonated with me and stuck with me, considering the fact that I was kind of raised that way. You know, my mother's a white Dominican, my father's a very, very dark black Dominican. And, my mom never really embraced the dark side of the family. You know what I'm saying? So it really resonated with me. And there's a scene in the film that's actually, that we had to remove. We're saving it for later, you know, where I'm in the hospital after my wife gets shot. And, I'm having this argument with my mother about, you know, having, like, you know, a dark-skinned wife and kind of,
My name is Ronnelly. I'm the writer director of the film. There goes the executive producer right there, Sean Lindsay. So the film is loosely based on his life, so that's Prophet right there.
Thanks,
bro. All right.
I am Marquise Jackson, and I play Lil Bam.
What's your name? I'm Leo Arias, and I play Santiago.
Hi, I'm
Michelle,
and I play Crystal.
Like I mentioned earlier, I'm from Freddie Benton. I play Man, and also one of the producers.
I'm Sean Lindsay, and this guy didn't give me no name in the movie.
So I'm pretty much be taking questions now.
Story. And I was a little scared on doing something like that because I thought maybe the folks may not be able to follow that kind of a story, but I realized that the way TV is going, reality TV, the way things with people are so wanted action and story just to happen so frequently. So I attempted to intertwine like four different storylines in that, which make one big story. And the real big thing about this film to me is the new talent that's on this film. Like I said, you guys have to agree, there are some really great actors. A lot of these guys are first-time actors. Marquise did an excellent job. Leo, excellent. My lady Nisha's excellent. Efi. There was another young lady on there that I just gotta say that Turtle twisted my arm and used him, and she was amazing. The girl played Chris Sandra, Chinese. The story is I'm a director that likes to have people rehearse, and I want to sit down with you, I want to talk to you. And so originally we had somebody else for that role, and as we're about to shoot the scene, Turtle comes in and says, "Nah, I want to use somebody else." I'm like, "You gotta be joking, brother, I don't do that." I'm like, "Nah, trust me. The girl got on that scene and she just lit it up, and it was an amazing, it was the scene where the mother and the daughter was shooting drugs up, and the girl, the first time acting, first time doing that scene. And the thing about it, why it was so real for her, was that actually happened to her. So that's why it was such a real scene for her. So these stories are relatable in our community, and the actors that took part in this film a real talent that I hope we get to see in other films.
Initially, I didn't even get a chance to read the script at first. My mom read it first, and she told me, she's like, "Oh, you have to read it." And my mom said something, it's like, "Oh, okay." But once I read it, though, it's something that just grabbed me, because it's not like the typical shoot 'em up, bang bang type of movie. It touches on so many different aspects of drug use or the cycles of drugs. So that's why I thought it was like a different aspect, and I just drove to it ever since. So once I got to meet the cast though, it was so like such a home and family feel. It just made it that much easier to, it just made a better working environment. So it felt like it wasn't forced or anything, it was so fluent. But yeah, the script is just so amazing. I was like, I have to do this no matter what, so yeah.
MREC, right? It's your boy Marquise, man. You're not throwing the MREC TV.
Yes, MREC, you know I rap NYC, and I'm the best ever, Mayweather TBE.
Oh yeah, subscribe to MREC TV, youtube.com/MREC TV. I'm gone.
MREC TV.
It's got a music.